jellyfish based on basically what size of prey they can take, depending on the strength of their sting. So we have a lot of different types of jellyfish here at the aquarium that we have to provide food for. But luckily, we're able to raise a lot of that food in-house, which means that we can make sure that it's going to be nutritious for each jelly that we feed it to. We're going to feed them some really small and concentrated food. This is really concentrated rotifers, which is a tiny, tiny plankton, and concentrated ovarian tissue. So it's like a jellyfish smoothie. That helps ensure that they're getting variety. And since they're so small, the food in here is so small, a jellyfish that doesn't have a really strong sting can still eat this food. So then I'm gonna mix in brine shrimp nauplii. Nauplii is just the scientific name for this stage of the shrimp larva. A lot of crustaceans go through a pretty intense molt sequence before they get to their adult stage. But the good news about this stage of brine shrimp is that it's really easy to enrich them. We can feed them food that's really high in different vitamins. They eat that food, and then the jellyfish eat them, and they get that nutrition as well. So that's why we choose to feed brine shrimp nauplii, brine shrimp larvae, as part of their diet. So I'm going to mix these together and make our morning smoothie. And then we'll just pour some of this in here. The tank is designed with special flow that is not only good for how the jellies move around, but it can distribute the food pretty well too. And you'll notice what you might have thought was some sort of orange juice or orange colored drink is actually a lot of tiny little specks. So as it hits the water, it starts to sort of dissipate and break into the individual shrimp nauplii. And that way it's creating like plankton in the ocean, which is what jellies would be eating out in the ocean.